Let's do the most interesting process in the tutorial series. It contains a process of moving hands of the robot arms like 3D animation. Open the Any Portrait Editor and create control parameters to move the fingers of the robot. Create control parameters for each finger. Set the type property as float and set the range as from -1 to 1. The default value is 0, which means that when you change to a value of -1 or 1, the fingers will be folded and unfolded. Control parameters are created for each finger. Select the mesh group and add the Morph by Controller modifier. Select one of the right thumb meshes, and press the red recording button of the control parameter to be connected to it. Select another mesh of the thumb and press the Add to Keys button to connect to the current modifier. Press the button in the lower left or the shortcut A key to turn on the edit mode, and move the slider for the control parameter. Let's make it look like that the thumb is unfolded. Even if it is not really a 3D model, you can make it considering the three-dimensional shape. Compare the poses by moving the slider to see if it moves naturally, and let's modify it. At this time, it is convenient to use the onion skin function. It is recommended that you select the default key, register it to the onion skin, and then create a modified posture. I made the thumbs motion while continuing to check that it moves naturally. Next, let's create a folded thumb. Deform the poses checking continuously by using the onion skin and the slider. The motion of the thumb is finished, but I tried to improve it a little more. Now it seems to be moving quite nicely. Select the second finger and do the same way. Create a key by connecting it with the another control parameter, and create folded and unfolded poses. It's hard to work because the other fingers cover the target. Click the I button in the list UI to hide covering fingers. This job is fun, but there's a lot of trial and error. Let's work deforming vertices one by one. If you have made the more detailed meshes, you can produce better results, but that will increase your working time. Therefore, I recommend that you create a simple mesh and produce a suitable result. The second finger is also finished. It looks like the real robot is working as two fingers move. Create the motions for the remaining fingers in the same process. I found that one mesh was created incorrectly before I started working. It is possible to modify the mesh even if the modifier is already applied. Select the mesh with the error and make the correction. This process took a very long time, so I will play at a fast speed. The action is the same as the played part of the video. It is not easy to make 2D illustrations look like 3D. You can create nice quality animations through repeated editing and testing. All the fingers of the right hand have been linked with the control parameters. Run the bake process to see how it looks in the scene. Control parameters can be controlled in the Inspector UI. All the fingers of the robot's right hand move quite nicely. Through the same process, the left hand of the robot is made to be deformed. You can create a three-dimensional movement by modifying the illustration with the morph modifier. In the next video, I will show you the process of adding bones for the animation. Thank you.